In this short video, let's quickly talk about one of the fundamental principles behind designing a survey, and that is measuring the variables and calculating the effect. This is something that often student researchers can't seem to wrap their heads around, so let's take a look at an example. I have here a research proposal from a bachelor student, and this student is trying to investigate, among other things, how various job-related factors may contribute to an employee's overall job satisfaction in a particular hotel. So, he designed a survey in order to collect some data. In his draft survey, he first tries to tap into overall job satisfaction with just one question. Please rate your overall job satisfaction at this hotel on a 7-point scale, with 1 being low and 7 being high. This is fine. This is perfectly acceptable because according to literature, one can indeed use a single global rating question to tap into overall job satisfaction. And then he has a number of questions to measure how various things may be related to or influence job satisfaction. And he phrases these survey items. Please rate the influence of colleagues and managers on your job satisfaction at this hotel. Please rate the influence of organizational culture on your satisfaction at this hotel. Please rate the influence of your hourly wages on your satisfaction at this hotel, so on and so forth. Now, these questions are somewhat problematic. They are not so good because they violate the principle of measuring the variables and calculating the effect. Instead, these questions are directly trying to measure the influence or the relationship between variables. By the way, for the purpose of this video, we will not distinguish between correlation and causation, so I use the terms relationship, influence, and effect interchangeably. Okay, so what this student is planning to do is that he wants to use a mean score of a survey item to represent how employees' perception of coworkers and managers may influence their overall job satisfaction. So essentially, instead of measuring the two variables separately and then calculating the correlation or the effect size, he is directly asking employees to give him this correlation, and that, theoretically and strictly speaking, is incorrect. So how should we change the wording of these survey items in order to correct this? Well, we should ask something like this in the survey. At work, my relationships with coworkers are positive. At work, I get along well with my managers. I consider my hourly wages to be fair. I believe in the norms and values represented by this company's mission and vision. Guests typically tip generously when paying their bills. So on and so forth. And then finally, my overall job satisfaction in this company is on a scale of 1 to 7, 1 being low, 7 being high. You see the difference? In this way, we first measure employees' perceptions regarding several key job-related factors, then we measure their overall job satisfaction, and then, on the basis of all the data collected, we can run some correlations or regressions in order to judge how these different independent variables may relate to or influence the dependent variable of overall job satisfaction. We can also see, when we run the regression analysis, which of the independent variables are the most important predictors, relatively speaking. So, if you are designing a survey because you are investigating the relationship between variables, or if you are investigating how a number of predictors may actually influence a particular outcome variable, remember this. Measure the variables and calculate the relationship or the effect. Okay, good luck with your research, and as always, thanks for watching this Ranywayz random video. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.